Whenever someone asks me what's the most important thing in a smartphone, I have only one answer, that is the software. Now, iPhones are known around the world for giving the user a great software experience. Now, with the launch of the iOS 14, I think people have outdone themselves. Let's see how. Hey guys, you're watching PC Media. I'm your host Shaumit Seth, and today we are having a look at the public version of the iOS 14. So without any further ado, let's get started. So I have been using iPhones for quite a long time, and I personally feel that the iOS 14 is best among all the iOS softwares that they have launched in the previous years. This iOS 14 has some of the outstanding features which are user friendly, and that makes the deal. Like, that's the best deal that a consumer can get when it comes to an iPhone. So upcoming are some of the best features that I feel you should use, and that makes it all for this video. So sit back and enjoy the features. The first feature on the list is the app library. The app library is a new screen that positions itself at the end of your home screen pages. It automatically organizes all of your apps into folders such as social or recently added, as well as suggestions, showing up apps that might be useful at that particular time. You will be able to choose how many home screen pages to display and hide entire pages for quick access to the app library. You can also access a particular app directly through the app library, which makes your life much easier and refines your iPhone's experience. The second feature on the list is the widgets. Previously, widgets were only available on today's screen, but with iOS 14, new widgets will offer up timely information at a glance, and you will be able to pin them onto any home screen page in different sizes. Yes, it's just like the widgets on Android and indeed the live titles on Windows Phone. There's a new plus icon in the top left corner which enables you to add widgets depending on what is installed. You can also choose to scroll through more options for each widget, or just drag widgets onto the home screen or today's screen. The next feature on the list is the most important feature if we look at the current scenario. Yes, the COVID-19 exposure notifications. Your iPhone can tell you if you may have been exposed to COVID-19. Your public health authorities' guidelines determine if an exposure is significant enough to notify you and provide the next steps. Exposure notifications keep a log of possible exposure on your iPhone while protecting your privacy. The region you select is only used to download the configuration for that region. So I personally feel that it more or less like the Arogya Setu app offered by the government of India. Now with this feature, I think iPhone aims at a more safer and healthier audience. The next feature on the list is the Smart Stack that automatically rotates widgets to show the most relevant information throughout the day and can also be flipped through easily. You can usually use the Smart Stack for viewing the city in which you are living, the temperature of that city, and the climate of that city. The next feature that I'm going to be talking about is an accessibility feature known as the back tap, which allows you to perform actions quickly by double or triple tapping the back of your iPhone. There's an entire list of interesting features that you can do with double and triple tap. Now this feature will change the way you will use your iPhones in the future. The double and the triple taps allow you to surf faster on your phone, open app control center, and even switch between apps, which makes your life much more easier when it comes to surfing on iPhones. The next features that are on the list are related to the Face ID, namely the attention aware features and the haptic on successful authentication. iPhone will check for attention before dimming the display, expanding a notification when locked, or lowering the volume of some alerts. It will also play haptic when Face ID successfully unlocks iPhone, authorizes Apple Pay, or verifies iTunes and App Store purchases. Now these features are very user friendly and make your iOS feel more optimized. There are a bunch of new and great looking wallpapers that have been added in the wallpaper gallery with the iOS 14. These wallpapers will make your home screen and lock screen look more colorful and great. The next feature on the list is the Switch Control. Switch Control allows you to use your iPhone by sequentially highlighting items on the screen that can be activated through an adaptive accessory. So our loving Siri has been redesigned in iOS 14. So now it pops up on the page you're on instead of opening up a whole new screen. It's getting a host of new features too, including better translation functionality and expansion of knowledge. You will also be able to start to record and send an audio message using Siri. Apple has replaced the old AirDrop feature with the new Near Field Communication or NFC, which enables devices within a radius of 4 cm to exchange information wirelessly. There's an addition of a new plus button on the top left corner of the iPhone that will help you in editing the widgets, adding new widgets to the home screen, and creating a better layout for your home screen. The next feature is the motion feature that has three sub features: the reduced motion feature, the autoplay message effects, and the autoplay video previews. Now, the reduced motion feature reduces the motion of the user interface, including the parallax effect of icons. The autoplay message effects allows full screen effects in the messages app to autoplay, and the autoplay video previews allows to play videos automatically in full screen. Overall, the iOS 14 is compact, simple, and easy to use, and comes with a bunch of user-friendly features that enhances accessibility and user's experience. So these were some features that were really user-friendly in the iOS 14. There were many other features that were on the beta or the developer version of the iOS 14, but they were not able to make it on the final version. Now, if you haven't installed the iOS 14 update, it has been publicly rolled out for iPhone 8, iPhone 10, and rest of the iPhone 11 series. So if you haven't installed your iOS 14, then just go and install it and feel the innovation. Okay guys, so that's it for this video. So this was my take on the iOS 14. So if you have any queries regarding this iOS 14, so you can feel free to ask me in the comment section below, and I would be happy to answer to all of them. With that being said, if you haven't subscribed to our channel, then do consider subscribing to our channel and press the bell icon so that you get notified whenever I upload a new video. And also, if you haven't followed us on Instagram yet, we upload some beautiful wildlife photography there. So if you want to see those wildlife photography, you can follow us with the link in the description. With that being said, I would see you in my next video. Bye-bye. Take care and stay safe.